Now, your instinct might be that this has just gone too far and this is not what the pilgrims had in mind. Well, of course it wasn't. They hadn't yet circled the globe and found Italy yet. Hi again, and welcome back to the channel. My name's Chris, and we have so much ground to cover today, I just want to jump in and get started. So the first story that we're going to cover today is about a man named Kyle Scheel. Kyle's a motivational speaker and TikTok content creator out of the state of Missouri. Recently, he was at the Midwest gas station chain Come and Go, which is not something that my twisted mind made up. I can actually confirm their existence, having stopped at several on prior road trips. I even own a koozie around here somewhere that reads Come and Go on it that makes me laugh every single time I come across it. Personally, I like to think their slogan is Come and Go. No, we don't offer that. Stop asking. So through happenstance, Kyle is at a come and go, probably buying a bag of chips or filling up gas or something, and he notices in the middle of the room there's a giant advertisement that's standing there. And you know the ones that I'm talking about. You know, you'll see like a giant LeBron James cutout standing in the center of the room holding like a giant Hershey bar advertising $2 for $1. And depending on whether or not he's suspended at the time, sometimes it is actually LeBron James. So Kyle's fascinated by this and he decides to make some small chat with the employees, and it turns out they don't actually know where they come from. Some dudes from corporate just show up in trucks, drop these promotions off, and then move along. The cashiers just keep on keeping on. They're just paid to scan the item and then charge you whatever the register tells them to. So Kyle pauses, thinks about it, and has a completely devilish idea. And rather than have me fill you in, I think I'm gonna pause right here and let Kyle tell you himself.
So as soon as he said that, I immediately knew, okay, I'm gonna make a cardboard cutout of myself and I'm gonna put it inside a gas station.
I figured the more official this looks, the less likely they'll be to take it down, so I decided to add a dramatic backdrop. Take me home, country roads. Looks like a billboard for a Branson show. Perfect. It still needed something, so I added this text that says the Kyle Scheele meal. I have no idea what that is, but I've always wanted my own influencer meal. Okay, I didn't realize the glare was gonna keep you from seeing what's actually happening, but here's me carrying in the cutout.
So there was a problem that Kyle hadn't accounted for. He shared it to his super heavily followed TikTok account, and then more and more shares of it were blowing up as it went viral. People figured out which come and go it was at and started taking videos of themselves asking for the Kyle Scheele meal at the store. The store employees have absolutely no idea what this is, so they're just being flooded with question after question about the Kyle Scheele meal and have absolutely no idea what to tell the customers. So at this point, because it's gone viral, Come and Go was made aware of it. And thankfully, they're the kind of company with a sense of humor that you would expect from a company called Come and Go. So, Come and Go immediately blows its wad at having its stores being talked about in a viral manner, and rather than turf the signage, they smartly lean into it. So if you've been in an area serviced by a Come and Go, you can head in and purchase the Kyle Scheele meal, where you get two slices of crappy gas station pizza and a Red Bull for just $5. Now here's the cool part. $2 from every single purchase, up to $10,000, is gonna be donated to the No Kid Hungry Fund, and Red Bull has even offered to match those donations from Come and Go. And that's the part of the story that I love about this. For all intents and purposes, this was just a prank designed to draw eyeballs to Kyle's personal TikTok page so he can sell a little bit of merchandise, like the Never Grow Up hoodie. Instead, Kyle's able to catapult his 15 minutes of fame into landing a coveted partnership with Come and Go, and does a little bit of good to fight hunger on a week where Americans are thanking their blessings anyway. So good job on him. And thinking of giving thanks, a Cheektowaga pizza joint called Macy's Place has decided to get stuffed. They went ahead and got their gobble on with a Thanksgiving pizza. It's a pizza topped with turkey, mashed potatoes, stuffing, corn, gravy, and cranberry drizzle. And if you're not in the mood for pizza, but wings are more your speed, you can also trade in your traditional buffalo style for Thanksgiving style, which are wings that are drenched in gravy, corn, and mashed potatoes with cranberry sauce for dipping. Now your instinct might be that this has just gone too far and this is not what the pilgrims had in mind. Well, of course it wasn't. They hadn't yet circled the globe and found Italy yet. But you'd bet if they had, their first thought when eating the pizza might have been, man, this is perfect exactly the way it is. Followed by, how can I alter this in an offensive but delicious new way? Look, food is just a canvas for expression, and Macy's Place, do not let the naysayer stop you. Just make sure that if you serve up a pumpkin pie pizza next year, that you remember to pack the whipped cream on the side. Now, before we get to our final story, if you're looking to give me a little bit of thanks this year, smashing the subscribe button and liking this video would go a long way. It's free, it helps my channel, and I always appreciate it. So finally today, are you intimidated with cooking your Thanksgiving turkey? Does your bird come out with rubbery skin instead of crispy? Are you looking for the perfect brine recipe or perhaps seasoning? Well, Butterball is here to save you with their turkey hotline. by dialing 1-800-BUTTERBALL, and this is true, you'll be paired with one of their 50 turkey experts who've been helping frustrated Kitcheneers for over 40 years. They're open in November and December to Americans, and as somebody on Reddit shared, it's very wholesome and feels like being able to call your grandma for cooking advice. And look, if you're somebody who doesn't want to talk on the phone, they've even expanded their support to text, online chat, email, and even Facebook, Instagram, and somehow TikTok. One thing I've learned, however, is they're just an advice line and not miracle workers. So if you're removing a turkey from the freezer at 10 a.m. on the big day and need to have it ready for dinner at 6, your next call should probably be going to Macy's Place for a Thanksgiving pizza. So, what do you think? Have you ever called a food support line for help? Did Macy's Place completely drop the ball by not including green bean casserole on the pizza? And have you ever visited a come and go and lived to tell the story? Comment below and tell me all about it, and share any other food-related stories with me at any time. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. I'll see you on the next one.